A WHO scientist, or World Health Organization scientist, who initially dismissed the lab leak theory, now calling it probable. He now says the pandemic may have started when a Wuhan lab worker was infected by a bat. Let's bring in Republican Congressman from New York, Lee Zeldin. He's a member of the House Foreign Affairs Committee. Congressman, welcome. So first off, will Congress investigate this new development as part of its probe into the source of this virus?
I'm sure that you're going to see a continuation of the Republican-led probes to dig into every lead that we get. There is a responsibility on the part of the majority party to do the same diligently. Fortunately, the effort led by Michael McCaul in the House has already led to a lot of new developments and a better understanding of what took place. But the short answer to your question is yes, absolutely. I just don't have the answer for you as to whether or not Nancy Pelosi is going to make it a top priority.
Well, that's interesting. The former State Department investigator that we have been talking with throughout, David Asher, on this current probe, he says this has not been conducted as an investigation. To your point, here he is in his own words.
This has not been conducted as an investigation. It's been sort of an intel project. An investigation would assume that we've got a crime scene, a crime was committed, a cover-up has happened.
So how confident should we be knowing all this and seeing this major reversal, if you'll call it that, on the part of the World Health Organization? How confident are you that the Biden-led investigation, 90 days coming up the end of this month, will reveal anything at all or be conclusive in any way?
At this point, not confident. And certainly, just like my colleagues, we all should maintain an open mind. But based off of what we've learned so far, I'm not confident. I do know that the House-led effort, Michael McCaul, has put together a detailed report as well as updates and annexes to it, where we've learned about the gain-of-function research that took place and the safety and security issues at the lab, the timing with evidence of a lab leak around late August, early September of 2019. The scramble to cover up between Wuhan scientists as well as the CCP, the requests for additional funding that took place at the lab, and the military world games that took place, where you have people who then go back to their countries around the world and they start the spread of the virus. Fortunately, that very competent work is being done. Unfortunately, it's being done by one party, and the House Republican effort has been fantastic on it so far.
All right, we'll see. Want to transition to Afghanistan now. Obviously, you've seen the outpouring of responses, including Mike Pompeo, who warned last night about the consequences we might suffer here in the homeland as a result of the Taliban taking over control after the troop withdrawal on the part of the United States. The Pentagon press secretary, Kirby, is basically saying that this situation in Afghanistan, it is deteriorating. Here he is in his own words. Listen.
The military will still remain committed to helping protect the diplomatic presence that remains inside Afghanistan. So nobody is abandoning Afghanistan. It's not walking away from it. It's doing the right thing at the right time to protect our people.
We are expected to get an update from the Pentagon top of the hour, 2 o'clock Eastern time. This is the United States, Congressman, has announced they're sending 3,000 troops in for this partial Afghan embassy evacuation that they see is needed at this time as the Taliban continues to take over. How concerned are you about the situation there?
Extremely concerning and very predictable that what we are witnessing unfold right now is a total collapse of the security situation, a pending total collapse of the government there in Afghanistan. This was very predictable. The United States forfeited away the leverage that was needed to withdraw in the right way. There's a lot of fatigue because we've been in Afghanistan so long, but it's not that there isn't any right way or wrong way to do things with regards to a withdrawal in the manner in which the Biden administration has focused this debate. We need to bring Secretary of State Blinken before Congress to answer questions about what the plan is from that diplomatic level. We need to bring General Austin and the Chief of Staff, Mark Milley, before the Armed Services Committee to answer questions about the plan. First and foremost, we do have United States personnel on the ground, and we need to protect their safety. We also have to be sympathetic to all the sacrifice that's been made over the past few years and what is really ultimately the last couple of decades because you have American families who are watching what took place, a great sacrifice, and most personally for their family. So this has to be done correctly. The fatigue as far as being there so long is shared by everybody, but the way this is being done guarantees a total imminent collapse to terrorists. And that is what bothers many people, myself included.
That is quite a warning, Congressman. Appreciate you joining us. Again, we'll be listening for that update from the Pentagon, expected top of the hour. Congressman, thank you.